Here's how to use Google Sheets. Use the clickable sections below to skip through different parts of this tutorial. Once logged in, click on the Google Apps icon at the top right corner of your screen. A drop-down menu will appear. Scroll down and select Sheets to start. You can also launch Sheets through Google Drive. Click on Plus New, Google Sheets, and then Blank Spreadsheet. When using Sheets, Google Drive automatically saves everything as you go. Just make sure you're connected to the internet. You'll be presented with a blank sheet and other template options. Google Sheets offers ready-made templates for personal and business use, such as the invoice template, weekly planner, and expenses report. We'll start with a blank sheet. To name your sheet, click on Untitled Spreadsheet and type the name. Choose the location of your file by clicking on the folder icon. You'll be able to choose from an existing Google Drive folder or create a new one. Each document is made up of a sheet. You'll see this at the bottom where it says Sheet 1. You can have multiple sheets within each document. To add a new one, click on the plus icon. To rename your sheet, double-click on Sheet 1, type your new name, and press Enter. Click on the arrow positioned next to the title to see more ways to organize your sheet. You can duplicate your sheet or copy it to another spreadsheet. To keep certain sheets private within a document, you can activate a password by clicking here. You can also change the color of your sheet by hovering your cursor over Change Color and then selecting one. To import data into your sheet, go to the top menu and click File and then Import. A pop-up menu will appear, and you'll be presented with options of where you can upload your file from. Let's upload an Excel file from our computer. Click on Upload and click Select File from your device. Select your file and then click Choose. Google Sheets will ask you how you'd like to format your uploaded data. You can create a new spreadsheet, replace data at selected cell, or replace the entire spreadsheet. We'll select to create a new spreadsheet. You'll need to ensure that your Excel file is converted to ensure it works properly in Google Sheets. To do this, go to the Google Drive Settings tool. Click on Settings, then click the box next to Convert Uploads. Your files will now be automatically converted in the future. The sheet consists of cells, columns, and rows. Columns are indicated alphabetically at the top and rows numerically down the side. You can select each column or each row by clicking on its letter or number. You can double-click on a cell, type some information, and press Enter. When using Google Sheets, you'll want to know which cell your information is in when using formulas. Each cell is named by the column letter, followed by the row number. Let's click on this cell. The column G is highlighted at the top. The row 9 is highlighted on the left. G9. You can select multiple cells, which is useful when you need to create formulas or want to move cells around. Click on a cell and drag your cursor across other cells to select a group. Let's select all of our cost prices. We'll click on C5 and then drag down to C13. Once selected, you can hover over the edge of the selection until you see the grab icon. Click and drag to move your cells around. When using formulas in Google Sheets, you may need to refer to a group of cells you're selecting. This is called the range. This range would be called C5:H13. You can use basic formulas in Google Sheets. To create a formula, select the cell where you want to see your answer. At the top of your screen, click on the white bar next to the FX sign. This is where the formulas are stored for each cell. you'll be able to write formulas here as well as edit them. Let's use a formula to add up how much stock we have. First, double-click where you want the total, and then type the equation in the FX bar. Always start a formula with an equals sign, followed by the formula instruction. Type equals, followed by sum in capital letters, followed by open bracket, followed by the range. Our range is from D5 to D13, as these are the numbers we want to total. So we'll type D5 colon D13, followed by a closed bracket sign to complete the equation. Press enter. If the formula has been entered correctly, the total will immediately be shown in the cell. If you've made a mistake, perhaps you've misspelt something, an error symbol will appear like this. Then you should go back to your FX bar and you can edit it until it's correct. You can learn how to create other formulas by learning the Google Sheets language. Create a header so it remains at the top of your sheet when you scroll down. Hover your mouse over the grey line at the bottom of the top left corner cell, and it'll turn blue. Click on it and drag past the header cell and release. All the cells in row 1 are now a header. You can use the same method to lock cells in a column. Customize your header by clicking on it and using the format icons at the top of your page. First, highlight the data you want to use in your chart. Then go to Insert and click on Chart. Your chart will appear alongside an editing window. To change from a 2D bar chart to a different style of graph, select Chart Type and choose the design you want. You can add a series to your chart by selecting Add Series. To delete it, click on the three dots and then select Remove. For more ways to change your chart, click on the Customize tab. To change your background color and format your chart, click on Chart Style and select your preferences.